With more people using Starport to build blockchains, in V16 we decided to improve the installation process, expand scaffolding functionality and reliability, add Kepler and Relayer to the view front end, and more. Starport can be installed with a single command in the terminal. It's incredibly easy already, but in this release we went further than that. Now all dependencies are bundled with the binary, including proto-C and required protocol buffer files. So the only things you need are Golang and Starport binary. Let's scaffold a new Cosmos SDK chain and open it in a text editor. Being a modular framework, Cosmos SDK provides standard modules, lets you write your own, and import third-party modules. All of them expose HTTP API endpoints. Starport now automatically generates OpenAPI documentation for standard, custom, and imported modules for your chain, and embeds these docs into the nodes binary and exposes them on the default API port. Let's now scaffold a custom type with CRUD operations for a module called chain and run Starport serve again. The chain restarts, and if you open the default API port, you will see two new endpoints available. You can see params they accept and make HTTP requests. The OpenAPI document is generated by default in the docs directory. You can use it, for example, to publish your chain's API online. This, of course, can be customized in the config.yaml file. We've also made some changes to the web front end. You may have noticed that Starport serve no longer starts the front end automatically. To get the front end up and running, run npm install and serve. Decoupling the node from the front end allows for more customizability and lets you debug the front end more easily. In this release, we've added support for the popular Kepler wallet. Start using it, approve chain request, and Kepler account will be added alongside other accounts. Another cool feature that's been added to the Starport front end is in-browser IBC Relayer. Let's copy a mnemonic of one of the accounts generated by Starport and import this account into the front end. We'll now go into the new Relayer section. With the in-browser Relayer, you can connect to any chain. There is also a shortcut to connect your chain directly to the mainnet Cosmos hub, and that's what we'll do right now. Before we connect our new local chain to the hub, we need to send Adam to our Relayer account. I've copied the Relayer address, and I'm using the Kepler wallet to send real atoms to this account. Since this is a throwaway account, I'm sending just enough atoms for the Relayer to establish a connection and relay packets. Once the transaction is processed on Cosmos Hub, and our local Relayer has some funds to operate with, we can use the Connect Relayer button to initialize the process. The Relayer will create light clients, initialize connections, process acknowledgements, and in the end, establish a working IBC connection between our local chain and Cosmos Hub. Let's copy Alice's address and send stake tokens from our local chain to her address on Cosmos Hub through IBC. After we specified the target chain, address, amount of tokens, and fees, we can send our transaction. After the transaction is processed, we can see it in the list of transactions below. We can use any Cosmos Hub full node to query the balance of Alice's address on the hub. We can see 3,000 IBC tokens successfully transferred to the hub. Since Alice's account was used as a Relayer account, we can also see atoms we sent to fund the Relayer. We can also go to mintscan the block explorer and see these transactions as they appear on the hub. This is how easy it is to set up a chain and connect it through IBC with any other chain, including mainnets like Cosmos Hub. You can also use the Relayer from the CLI without having to keep the browser open. Starport Relayer has two easy-to-use commands, configure and connect. You can also use the low-level TypeScript Relayer commands to set up everything manually. Now let's talk about code scaffolding. We've added a query command to scaffold a single query, which is very convenient, especially if you don't need the extra code that comes with type scaffolding. The type command also got a new flag that lets you scaffold a type without messages related to CRUD. a more lightweight alternative if you know you'll not be using messages. Another useful feature we've added is the ability to scaffold modules and chains that weren't created with Starboard. For example, let's open Gaia, the source code behind Cosmos Hub, and scaffold a new module. Gaia doesn't have custom modules, so there are no proto and x directories. Starboard scaffolded proto files and the module. It complained about not being able to register the module due to missing placeholders in app.go, but that can be done manually. Now that we've created a module with all the necessary placeholders, we can scaffold types, messages, and other components. This is very convenient because even if your chain's app.go was modified and placeholders removed, you can still benefit from Starboard scaffolding capabilities. In v16, we've also added new functionality to network commands. The chain command now lets you launch a chain from a custom initial genesis file, while join command now lets you pass gentx manually and specify the pure node address. In this video, we've reviewed some of the improvements we introduced with Starboard v16. It's becoming easier than ever to create a sovereign chain and connect it to other chains in the Cosmos ecosystem and beyond.